Over in Egypt, the Muslim Brotherhood accuses the army of wanting to drive Egypt to the same fate as Syria. This comes after soldiers allegedly killed 42 people holding a peaceful protest in Cairo. Warren de Guzman reports.
A massacre in Cairo. That's how Egypt's Muslim Brotherhood describes the shootings outside the Republican Guard headquarters early Monday. Supporters of ousted President Mohamed Morsi were holding a vigil when soldiers allegedly opened fire, killing dozens and wounding hundreds. Egypt's health ministry confirms women and children were among the dead.
We were praying at dawn when the army came with two armored personal carriers, two tanks and troops walking. They locked the door and threw bombs and ammunition.
But the army says a terrorist group tried to storm the headquarters, leaving five Morsi supporters and an officer dead. The army adds security forces were able to arrest 200 attackers, armed with guns and ammunition. Amid the conflicting accounts, the National Salvation Front, or NSF, is calling for an investigation. The NSF is an alliance of political parties formed when the recent turmoil over Morsi began. Opposition leader Mohamed El Baradei also condemns the violence, saying a peaceful transition is the only way. Hours before the violence, Interim President Adli Mansour nominated El Baradei as vice president and Ziad Baha'a El-Din as prime minister. Mansour will need to get political consensus before they are appointed. Morsi supporters still refuse to recognize Mansour and insist the deposed president must be reinstated. The military ousted Morsi late July 3, a few days after he marked 1 year in office. Millions had protested against Morsi, saying he achieved nothing as president. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.